How many agree with me today that when this life is over, that when we leave this place, we want to go to heaven? Come on.
I'm going to heaven, and I hope to see you there. Well, there's no more sickness in Hallelujah Square.
I'll see my father and my mother too. If you die in the will of God, I'll see you too.
Hold up in glory.
Hey, what's happening, brothers and sisters? We are back on another episode. Your TMA Radio broadcast, the best gospel, the best praise talk show in America. I'm your host, Pastor Accrington. We just kicking it back on this Thursday evening, 19 minutes past the hour. And we just going to play some music. We got some upcoming conversation that we'll tell you about. Weather, church news, the best of gospel music, and more. So stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
And every day is sunny and bright, no more clouds or rain,
where we can sing and shout and praise His holy name. Well, there'll be no more cares of this world ever again.
I heard the streets up there are paved with gold. Where there's so much love up there, you can rest your soul. That's where we'll meet our King and bow before His Majesty
and scream and praise His name for what He's done for me.
Hold up in glory, where we'll be together,
where we'll lift our hands and rejoice with Jesus Christ forever, yeah.
Hold up in glory when our race is won.
I wanna hear my Father say, I wanna hear Him say, well done.
Put your hands up, put your hands up. If you wanna go to heaven, put your hands up, put your hands up, put your hands up. If you wanna go to heaven, put your hands up.
Increase that trouble me. Many are they that rise up against me. Many there'll be which say of my soul, there's no help for him in God. But thou, O Lord, are a shield for me, my glory and the lifter of my head. And now my soul sings, great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. Oh, great is the Lord,
great is the Lord,
and
greatly to be praised.
Oh, let heaven,
heaven
and
earth
praise him. Oh, great is the Lord,
great is the Lord,
and
greatly to be praised.
Oh, great is,
great is,
the Lord,
the Lord,
great is,
great is,
great is,
great is,
oh, great is,
great is,
the Lord,
the Lord,
the one who created the heaven, the sun, moon, and stars, who founded the earth, and secured the waters deep, who commanded the sea to only go this far.
Great is the Lord,
the one who knew no sin,
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Greatly to be praised. Amen. I tell you right now, we are just blown away of the response we received about our broadcast on the other night. Because we need to have an address. We need to address the church. We need to address the church. And we have fallen short. Therefore, the enemy has come in and look like he is church, but it ain't the world. And so here you are. You got people shaking their bodies like they're in a nightclub. You got jokers supposed to be praising God but doing a break dance all in the church of God. And we sit back and don't want to say nothing because you say, oh, we judging. No, we got to correct some stuff. Well, at least we got to go out there and put it out right. Because you know what? Our great-grandparents and grandparents, they went and they were serious about the Lord. And they were praying before God. And they would tell them and teach their children, their grandkids, that you don't play in God's house. Come on, somebody. Amen. This is what we doing today. Playing in God's house. Them great grandparents and grandparents and granddaddies that were serious about they walk with the Lord, they didn't let you come up in the church house and do anything in the church house. Come on. They spoke and you listen. But today what we do, we don't want to offend nobody. We don't want to lose members. And better they be in here than to be out there on the street. Either way, whether you put discipline on in your house or not have discipline, people going to do what they want to do. Period. You let them do what they want to do, they still go out here and mess up. So either way, you better just go ahead and be right. So the conversation, hey man, we got an upcoming conversation again to continue our dialogue, our conversation on the body of Christ, the church, that we as the church has to get back in order. So we're going to have Pastor Carl back on the show as along with a music artist to put input and to share as well as all three of us in the dialogue. Hopefully we're praying that we'll have a mother that after we doing the conversation can share some insight. Because women, y'all done lost y'all mind. Y'all just do anything and it's all right. We don't have no more class, no self-respect. It's just, well, this is the new millennium and we can do what we want to do. I beg to differ. Because the Bible lets me know that I was bought with a price. I don't own myself. I bought with a price. And that price has been paid. But we ought to govern ourselves to say, Lord, I want to thank you. Yes, you know, everybody got an opportunity to get it right. And we all made some mistake because that's what we hear so much. You know, everybody done did something. Yes. But now that you done something, we ought to, what? Do better. You understand? Now, you might take a woman. Now, she might have been a loose woman. She might have been a woman that, boy, she had plenty of men all around town, this and that. And she got delivered and set free. And now she got a daughter. Do you think that she want her daughter to do the same thing she did all over town? No. She don't want men taking advantage of her daughter. If she done got delivered and chained, she going to teach her daughter what not to do. Amen. So she won't fall victim of being used up by men. Come on, somebody. Can I get an amen choir? Amen. Amen, microphone. Amen. This is what the conversation is, and we got to get back. You know, we are passionate about it because, one, we don't want to be you to be left behind. Two, we want to get us together because we ought to have some standard. You know? When they took prayer out of schools and we stopped praying before we ate in school, you remember they used to line us up. We say the prayer. We pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to which it stands, one nation under God. We don't say that no more. And look at what happened. When we took God out of the equation, look what happened. You understand what's going on? So this is why we got to have some standard in the church. You know, the church, you know, was a place that people respected, that when they really wanted change. You know, it remind me right now of the old movie. Y'all know that favorite all-time movie, The Color Purple. Oh, boy, when she was out of the church, when she was singing in the juke joint, oh, man, it was a hot time. Everybody was drinking. Oh, boy. But it was one day, my God, when she sung that song. But yes, she said, Daddy, sinners got a soul too. Yes, you got a soul too. But when you get delivered, the tears will fall. When you get delivered, amen, a change come. Yes, sinners have a soul too. Amen. But there's a time where we want to come to God and give God glory and give him praise. Amen. You know, God is a jealous God. And he's a loving God, but he also a God of wrath. And when God said, I'm tired of all this sin, I'm tired of all this envy, I'm tired of all this murder, he just take his hand back. After a while, he just let everybody do what they want to do. And then here he come. He come back for the ones that been crying out. The one that said, Lord, we need you now. Please, Lord, return back thou to us. Amen. Come back to us, O Lord. And then he'll come and take those enemies away and take those demonic spirits away from your home, and generational curses will be broken. Chains will be lifted up. Shackles are going to fall off. And people are going to go back to rejoicing and praising God. But we got to get some order back into the church. I'm sorry. They didn't have no crazy stuff going on in the temple. And if it was, it was corrected. And it shows you an example, Joker, with the money exchanges in the temple all changing, and everybody was doing their thing. And boy, that upset Jesus. And if it upset him, he was showing us the example that some things ain't to be done in the house. My God, see, y'all got to go there. You got to go there. Because people, if we don't stand, boy, I tell you, you're going to be so loose after a while. They're going to be back down like Babylonia. They're going to be hiding in the bottom of the church, having sex and everything else. If we don't start standing up again and getting order back in the house. Come on, I believe that we got to get some order back in the house, y'all. Amen. We got to get some order back in the house. You know, this was the time I was just reading this a couple of weeks ago. Matter of fact, might have been last month reading. And the people, oh, they thought God wasn't even around. They thought that they could go in the bottom of the basement, dig a hole somewhere down in the bottom of a corner somewhere and do their thing. They thought they could do their thing, but not so. And if we don't have a stand right on the step, people be doing it. Right on the church yard, people going to be doing what they want to do. If we don't keep talking what we're talking about now, this conversation. Amen. We got to talk the conversation. We got to have the conversation, y'all. Amen. Too, we done gone too long. Amen. Some things we can't address in full on at church service. We can discuss some things as the Spirit of God give it to us, but this is the platform. And we are thanking God that now we're going to go forth and be doing this on a regular. Anything to come up crazy, dealing with those leaders. But see, you ain't got to have the title of a preacher, a pastor, or evangelist, because you really, if you are ministering to God's people, and you saying that you're ministering to God first and then minister to the people, and God has anointed you to do so, then you got an instrument to draw. And so if you using your instrument to draw wrongly, And then the people are getting misled. Everybody gets confused and messed up. So we're going to continue the conversation on next Wednesday, 9 p.m. Y'all get y'all be ready. Mark your calendars. We're going to have the conversation part two of getting. We need to get the church. The church got to get in order. Everything going. As Pastor Carl stated, there was some praise dancing, dancing to a song that had cussing in it right there in the house of God. No more respect. My Lord. And everybody probably just sitting around smiling. People that want to say something ain't got backbone enough to say nothing. They don't like it, but they ain't going to say nothing. You see? And by them not saying that, they say, well, you know, we don't want the children to run away. They going to run away anyway. Because you don't let it get to a point that they're going to be out of control. And as soon as you try to change it, what they're going to do? Get mad and leave. They're going to say, you know what? You allowed us to do it. And now all of a sudden, now you want to change. You allowed us to listen to this music while we dance. And it had cussing in it. You were fine with it on that Sunday. Oh, now you want to change. So we ain't coming back. So see, you still stuck. You watch that. Yeah, you see how it had to work out? These preachers, these leaders, letting these people play this stuff in church. They dance to it because they say, we don't want the children to lead the church. We want to give them something to do. It's all right. But the moment that God touch your heart to change it, when you change it, they're going to say, well, you let us listen to it that one time. So now they're going to get mad and they still ain't coming back. So you might as well be right from the beginning and say, look, we ain't going to do this. So you might well have some standards at day one, because day two coming, you try to have a standard. It's going to be the same thing. They're going to leave. Either way, they might leave. Either way, they might leave. So you might as well stay firm on day one and stay right the rest of the way. That's it. That's what I'm talking about. So that's what we're going to be talking about on Wednesday. Wednesday, we're going to continue the conversation, y'all. And I just can't wait. And I want to hear what these mothers say, because we need some mothers to get up there and talk about some of the things they see these young ladies doing out here, carrying themselves in the kind of way, just open, just loose. My God, remind me of Esther on Fred Sanford. She said, I know this woman. This woman here is a loose woman. Night walker, day walker, loose. So we got to address some stuff, brothers and sisters. But anyway, we're going to continue to listen. We got weather, more information coming up, church news, and the best of gospel. So we'll be back. So stay tuned, and we'll talk to you in just a minute.
Let it rain, 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 open up the gates of heaven. Let it rain, open up the gates of heaven. Let it rain, 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 let it rain. Let it rain, 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 let it rain.
You're listening to the TMA Radio Show.
For me. Some of you need the house, you need the job, you need to be blessed financially. So your act of faith is simply turning around and saying, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. It has nothing to do with me. How many know if you just step out on faith, God will honor that and respond to your thank you? As we move, can I ask you a question? When will it come? When will it come? Jump up and get your blessing. When will it come?
Yes, test. Testing 1, 2. Testing 1, 2. Don't know what's going on. Testing 1, 2. Testing.
He's done so much for us. Amen. Can we thank God for all that he's done? We thank you, Jesus. Thank you for giving us your all, God. And in response, Lord, we just want to give our all back to you, Lord, and just say yes. God, you've done so much. How can we not give you our lives? How can we not give you our hearts, our gifts, our thoughts, God? We want to give it all to you, Jesus. We surrender our lives to you, Lord, and simply say yes to your plans, to your word, to your truth. We say yes to you, Jesus. Hallelujah. If that's your prayer this morning, you can lift your hands and sing with us. Even before we sing, we lift our hands and say yes, Lord. Before you even tell us, Lord, we say yes. Wherever you want us to go, we will go, God. Whoever you want us to speak to, we will speak to them, Lord God. We will share your goodness.
So all right, listen. We're going to go to the weather.
I'll just say yes. This life you gave.
Let's go to the weather forecast. Tonight, low of 36 degrees. Friday, mostly clear. High of 59 with a low of 39. Saturday, mostly cloudy skies. High of 66 with a low of 50. Sunday, high of 55 with a low of 33. Monday, high of 54 degrees with a low of 36 degrees. Tuesday, high of 60, partly cloudy with a low of 46. Wednesday, partly cloudy skies. High of 64 with a low of 47. And then Thursday, partly cloudy skies. High of 60. Lord, will you say yes? Will you say yes? Yes, Lord. Yes to your way. Yes to your will. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Come on. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Let's get that into our spirit. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Amen. Life is yours. Listen, we're going to continue the conversation on next Wednesday at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Our guest will be Pastor Carl Young. And also we have a special guest, a music artist, along with myself. And possibly a mother or two to share an input on the conversation of next week. Such a needed conversation. So we're thanking God that we'll be back here on next week, Wednesday. Excuse me. And also, this third Sunday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, we will have the Hour of Power with the Word. Apostle Simmons will be our speaker for the third Sunday Hour of Power. You can tune in by listening to this broadcast, or you can dial in the Circle of Love Prayer Partners Prayer Line at 218 248-2848, and the code is 81056. Again, that's this Sunday at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And then also, we want to welcome you to worship with us this Sunday at Healing Word Ministries. And we're located at 501 North Main Street inside of the Lewisburg College Chapel at 8:45 a.m. for a worship experience. Come on and join us as we go to God and praise and also hear word from the Lord. Again, that's 8:45. Lewisburg College Chapel, you all are welcome to join us. Amen. And I think we have no other announcements at this time. And we want you to know that we've been playing the best gospel it is around. So we want you to meet us here on starting on Sunday now. So tell your friend to tell their friend to join us starting this Sunday, and make sure you mark your calendars for this Wednesday coming up at 9:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, where we're going to talk about the things that we're discussing dealing with the church. It's time to get back in order. It's time to get back right. It's time to not let everything happen in the church of the Lord. We saw that when Jesus turned over the tables, angry and upset. The people can't do anything they want to do, and that's what's happening. We're letting it happen, and after a while, it's getting to get out of control to a point you sit back and say, man, I can't believe I let this happen. If you don't talk about it, you don't address it, and this is what goes on. But we got to have a stand. We got to have a stand. There's some things in some places, a time and a place for everything, and the world place is not in the church. We are the church, so we should be governing ourselves accordingly. Have some dignity, have some respect for ourselves, but most of all, if we're going to do this thing, let's do it. Amen? Let's do it. All right, we're going to continue to broadcast. We got two more songs for you before we go. And we love you with the love of the Lord. And we'll see you in just a bit before we sign off.
Those that know it and you want to stand and sing it with us, it's okay. Church choir, you can stand right where you are. Song says, I do. Thank you. your glory.
And your glory.
How many know God's gonna get his glory in the house? He's been real good to me. For your goodness.
For your goodness.
In spite of all you're going through.
Thinking of another minute, not an hour of another day. But at this moment when my arms outstretched, I need you may away. As you have done so many times before, through a window or an open door, I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me. I need you right away. I need you now. I need you now. I need you now. I need you now. Second, no, another minute, not an hour of another day. But Lord, I need you right away. If I never needed you before to show up and restore all of the things that I let slip. Yet searching the world for more, you're the truest friend I've had indeed. You're my best friend, I know indeed. Cause I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right away. The agony of being alone. And trials that come to me, Miss Strong. Feelings of guilt, hurt, shame, and defeat. The way the trials that beat on me.